All right, students, good evening. Chalo, we'll go ahead and revise with our next chapter on customs. Baba, the next chapter on customs is relating to classification of goods. Baba, let's link the previous chapter with this chapter now. In the previous chapter, we had learned about import procedure and export procedure. Import procedure, import means bringing of goods into India. Exports means taking of goods from India to outside India. If you have not seen the video, please go ahead and revise import and export procedure. Then come for this video. Now, in this classification, we will be learning, Baba, suppose this is India, goods have come into India. When goods come into India or goods go from India outside India, we need to go ahead and pay import duty or export duty. Sir, how do you calculate import duty? Basically, how do you calculate custom duty? You calculate custom duty as value of the goods which are imported or exported. Baba, I'll talk more about imports now. Value of imported goods multiplied by rate of exchange into rate of duty. Sir, value will be determined in under section number 14.1 or 14.2, which I'll teach you in the valuation chapter. Sir, once we know the value, supposingly I know the value is 10,000 rupees, rate of exchange, sir, for an example, 50 rupees dollar, per dollar is 50 rupees. Baba, we have imported goods of $10,000. Per dollar is 50 rupees. So 50,000 ka goods for an example only. Okay, sir, please take 70 note. Okay, let's take 70. So 70,000 ka goods into rate of duty. Sir, what rate of duty will be applicable on my goods? Supposingly I have imported mobile phone. Now you will tell mobile phone, I'll say camera. So what is this goods? So Baba, we have to classify this as mobile phone or we'll have to classify this as camera. That is very important because based on your classification, the rate of duty will be different. So Baba, rate of duty supposedly on mobile phone is 20%. Might be if we classify it as camera, rate of duty is 30%. So Baba, we will always try to classify where the rate of duty is less. Department will always try to classify where the rate of duty is more. Baba, government told you don't have to go ahead and worry. Baba, I will tell you how to go ahead and read the Custom Tariff Act and find out the correct rate of duty. Baba, classification of goods is nothing other than classifying your goods correctly in the Custom Tariff Act, basically locating your goods correctly in the Custom Tariff Act so that you determine the correct rate of duty. If you determine the correct rate of duty, you will be able to find out custom duty correctly. If you pay custom duty correctly, there will not be any show cause notice which will be issued by the department to you saying that classification has been done wrong. I hope everyone is clear. So for correct classification, we have to learn some rules which are there, some explanatory notes which are there, so that when we read the Custom Tariff Act, we read it correctly and find out the correct rate of duty. So in the classification chapter, we will be learning how to find out the correct rate of duty by various rules, by applying various rules, by learning about various explanatory notes which are there. So Baba, we will come to our chart. Chart first says classification. Baba, classification means nothing other than finding out your correct HSN code. Sir, HSN code? HSN code means harmonized system of nomenclature. Sir, what do you mean by harmonized system of nomenclature? Baba, rice might be called rice in India. Rice might not be called rice in Japan. Supposingly, I'm exporting rice. Baba, the person who receives in Japan, he sees the bill of lading or Baba, he sees the documents. He will be confused. What is rice? So Baba, World Custom Organization has developed a code for every article. So for every article, there is a code. Whenever you are exporting the goods, you should code that code correctly so that the person who has imported or he will be able to understand, oh Baba, rice has been received. So whenever we import the goods, if goods are coming from supposing Japan might be that goods are called something else. India might be that goods are called something else. So World Custom Organization, in order to harmonize the system of import and export, developed a code that Baba, whenever you are sending your goods, this code has to be quoted so that Baba, the person who is receiving or the person who is sending, he will be able to understand what are the goods which are received or what are the goods which are received, so that for him to file bill of entry, it becomes easy. Baba, when you are filing a bill of entry, you have to quote the correct HSN code, right everyone? Next, sir. Classification means finding out your correct HSN code, correct heading, subheading in the Custom Tariff Act. Custom Tariff Act has two schedules, first schedule, second schedule. First schedule gives you the import duty ka rate, second schedule gives you the export duty ka rate. Sir, import duty ka rates are told in first schedule, second schedule, export duty ka rate. Sir, second schedule mein supposedly export duty is not told about some item, Baba, it means that there is no export duty on that item. Most of the goods may export may, because the destination is outside India, most of the goods government have made sure that there is no export duty. However, some goods export duty is there because government doesn't want it to be exported in huge quantity, Baba, due to government ka own thoughts. Next, sir, what do you mean by HSN code? Baba, HSN code is nothing other than an 8-digit code. HSN code is nothing other than an 8-digit code. Baba, HSN code, if you see, I will show you this over here, everyone. HSN code, whenever you want to determine, you will have to, you will see that there are 8 digits. The first 2 digits are the chapter ka digits. Baba, the first 2 digits of the HSN code denote the chapter. The second 2 digits denote the heading. The third 2 digits denote the subheading. And the next 2 heading denote the tariff item. Sir, how do we understand this? See, Baba, when you go to the Custom Tariff Act, you will see there are 21 sections. Baba, can you guys see section number 1, section number 2? Like this, big, big sections are made. One section. Section number 1 consists of all the live animals, animal product. Section number 2, all vegetable product. Section number 3, Baba, animals and vegetable foil, fats and oils. Baba, section number 4 might be there is talking about textile. Section number 5 might be medical items. Section number 6 might be something else, again vehicles. Vehicles which includes all the train, rails, etc. So, Baba, on a larger point, they have gone ahead and made various sections. Basically, the industry which is there is divided into 21 sections. Under every section, you will have chapters. Can you guys see chapters? So, like that, we have in total 98 chapters. So, Baba, how many chapters are there? There are 98 chapters. Baba, like in IDT, we have how many chapters? Baba, 40 chapters are there in GST and 10 chapters are there in custom. For an example, 50 chapters are there. Sir, out of 50 chapter, there are 2 sections which are there. 40 are in section number 1, which is GST, and 10 which are there in section number 2, which is custom. I hope everyone is able to understand. So, basically, the chapters are divided into 21 sections. The chapters are divided into 21 sections. How many chapters are there? 98 chapters are there. 91 chapters are divided like 4 chapters, 4-5 chapters of each into 21 section. Then we have under the chapter, Baba, supposingly I am selecting section number 1. Baba, everyone, please be very careful. I am selecting section number 1. In that, I am selecting chapter number 1. So, Baba, if you go over here in section number 1, chapter number 1, you will see section number 1, chapter number 1, live animals. So, Baba, it is talking about live animals. So, Baba, if I tell you in which section we will find live animal, you will say section number 1, chapter number 1. Right, everyone? Now, if I go over here, then you have 01 is what? Chapter. 01 is what? Heading. Baba, heading is denoted by another 2 words, which is 01, 02, 03, etc. Sir, 01 is the chapter. In chapter number 1, heading number 2 says live bovine animals. Baba, 01 heading says live horses, asses, mules and hinds. Baba, don't go ahead and ask me to explain the meaning of this word. Please Google. Now, everyone listen. So, what I am telling you, animals, you will be able to see in Google. Everyone here. So, Baba, 01 is the chapter number, 01 is the heading. 01 is the chapter number, 02 is the second heading. So, Baba, under the heading 01, which is the chapter, you have subheading. Under the subheading, you have 21. 21 means, Baba, this is 01 chapter, this is 01 heading. Baba, 21 is the subheading. So, Baba, again, if you see over here, heading is denoted by 2 word. Subheading is further denoted by 2 word. Baba, chapter, heading, subheading. Chapter, 2 words, 2 digits. So, if they ask you in the exam, HSN code, 8 digits, please explain. First 2 digits, chapter. Second 2 digits, headings. Again, 2 digits, subheading. Sir, under the subheading, if you have sub-subheading, Baba, sub-subheading it is not called, it's called tariff item. It's called tariff item. So, if tariff item, if you see over here, 01 is the chapter, 01 is the heading, 29 is the subheading. Under that, you have 10, you have 90. Baba, these are known as tariff item. So, Baba, if I tell you tariff item, Baba, another 2 digits denotes the tariff item. So, if I tell you HSN code 8 digit, you will go ahead and tell me, sir, chapters are 2 digits, denote the first 2 digits denote chapter, the second 2 digits denote heading, another 2 headings denote subheading, and Baba, another 2 headings denotes tariff item. I hope everyone is clear. So what do you mean by HSN code? HSN code is just a system of name and number which is developed by the World Custom Organization. Sir, next. Sir, now whenever you are doing classification, you will always have to follow general rules of interpretation and you will have to follow some explanatory notes. Baba, there are 3 explanatory notes. There are 3 explanatory notes which are there. Baba, if you see over here, now when you are reading this tariff ka table, they are telling you over here how to read it. There are some explanatory notes which are given which explains about some things in the table. Sir, explains things about the in the table. Sir, they are telling explanatory note may, first explanatory notes talks about dash. What do you mean by dash? Sir, dash, if you see this table, dash means this heading ka articles which are there. This heading ka articles ka sub classification, like here horses are there. So Baba, asses will be here. So Baba, heading ka sub classification of articles of the heading is denoted by dash. So Baba, if you see 01 heading, in 01 heading, if you go ahead and sub classify all the articles, sub classify means horses I have put separately, asses I have put separately. So sub classification of the article is denoted by dash. Sir, that article which is there, if you go ahead and sub classify again, Baba, horses, if you go ahead and sub classify as pure breed horses, other horses, then it will be denoted by double dash. So double dash, what do you mean by double dash? See over here, I have written double dash means sub classification of the above dash. Basically sub classification of the dash is denoted by double dash. Then Baba, you have triple dash also, you have 4 dashes also. However, for your ICM material, they have gone ahead and told only dash and double dash. Now, if you want to understand triple dash, sir, what do you mean by triple dash? Sir, triple dash, what do you mean by triple dash? Triple dash or 4 dash is basically sub classification of the immediate dash or double dash. I hope everyone is clear. So Baba, heading is divided into articles by denoting dash. Under the article, you have subheading, under the double dash denotes sub classification of the immediate article. Baba, triple dash, sub classification of the dash or double dash. I hope everyone is clear. So it says, what do you mean by dash? Dash is sub classification of the articles in the heading. Sir, what do you mean by double dash? Double dash means sub classification of the immediate dash. Basically, dash ka, the article which is there, that is further divided, then it is double dash. Baba, even further divided, then it is triple dash. Even further divided, then 4 dash. I hope everyone is clear. Next. Sir, when you read this table, what is the second thing you will have to read? Baba, when I say percentage, this percentage 30%, 30% will be applied on what? They are telling 30%. You have to understand that 30% means 30% will be applied on the value determined under section number 14. Basically, this percentage will be applied on what? This percentage will be applied on the value which is determined. This percentage means the rate of duty which is to be applied on basically value of the goods. Percentage means percentage of the value of goods. Percentage means rate of duty which is basically to be calculated on the value of the goods. Then if you read this table, the next is notes which they are telling is, sir, if supposingly preferential rate is not there, then Baba, please apply standard rate. Preferential rate is applied whenever you go ahead and import from a most favored nation. Basically, if you import from a friendly nation, then government gives you preferential rate. Government gives you preferential rate, and in that scenario, might be the rate will be a little lower, 25%. However, sir, supposingly preferential rate is not there. Why preferential rate is not there? They are telling, Baba, if preferential rate is not there, please apply standard rate. Don't come and fight. I hope everyone is clear. So there are 3 explanatory notes which are there. Your exam question, it can come. What are the 3 explanatory notes? Number 1, dash. Dash means article. Dash means article of the heading. Double dash is the sub-classification of the immediate preceding article. Sir, triple dash or 4 dash, Baba, it's sub-classification of the immediate preceding double dash or dash. I hope everyone is clear. Article which is denoted by dash or double dash. Then, sir, what do you mean by percentage? Percentage is the rate of duty which is calculated as a percentage. Percentage means the rate of duty basically, which is calculated on the value of goods, which is determined under section number 14. Sir, if standard rate is not, if preferential rate is not there, then standard rate is applicable. That is the explanatory note number 3. Baba, this is one question which they can ask you in the exam. Very small question which they can ask. So please be careful. Now, one question which they go ahead and also ask is, when you see the tariff of the Custom Tariff Act, sir, how many columns are there? I will tell, there are 5 columns. Number 1, tariff item. Please be careful. D for description, U for unit, and Baba, then rate of duty may, you have standard rate, you have preferential area, say preferential rate of duty. So how many columns are there? There are 5 columns. Number 1, tariff item. Number 2, description. Number 3, sir, unit. Number 4, standard rate. Number 5, preferential rate. I hope everyone is clear. T, D, U. Tariff, description, unit. Baba, unit means grams or Baba numbers, etc. And Baba, standard rate and preferential rate. T, D, U. Sir, PR. Okay. Everyone, if you want to remember, you can remember it like that. Again, a 2 marks question which they can ask you. MCQs have come nowadays. So, please be careful. Right, everyone. So, if I tell you what are the 5 columns, please write over here only and keep. T, D, U, Sir, PR. T means tariff item. D means description. U means unit. SR means standard rate of duty. And Baba, preferential rate of duty on importing from preferential areas. I hope everyone is clear. Next. So, sir, now there are some general rules of interpretation. Whenever you are reading this table, basically whenever you are reading this table and trying to find out your rate of duty, there are some rules which you need to follow. So, Baba, we'll have to go ahead and start understanding with rule number 1. So, rule number 1, which is there, it says, Baba, title, you have to write over here, title of people who have my chart book, you can write. People who don't have the chart book, you can download the chart from rameshsoni.com. Right. Sir, title of section or chapters are for ease of reference. Baba, you have to write this like this. The title of the section or chapters are for ease of reference. They don't have legal force. Sir, what do you mean by title of section and chapter? If you see this, this is the section number 1, chapter number 1. Basically, I have downloaded this from the Custom Tariff Act. If you see over here, Baba, section number 1, it says the title of the section and chapter. What is that? Which is the title, Baba? Over here, this is the title of the section. This is the title of the chapter. They are telling the name of the title and chapter. Baba, if I show you over here, section number 1, what is the title of the chapter? That title of the chapter is live animal, animal product. And chapter ka name is what? Title is what? Live animals. So, they are telling, they are just for your ease of reference. When you classify, just by seeing them, don't classify. Please go inside, deep down inside, basically open the tariff and properly check inside and then only go ahead and classify. Classification to be done on what basis they are telling. Rule number 1 says, whenever you are classifying, don't classify on the basis of the title of the section or on the basis of the title of the chapter. Baba, when you go ahead and open chapter number 1, it comes like this. So, when you open chapter number 1, it will show over here, section number 1, chapter number 1. In section number 1, the name which is given, no, this is the title of the section. They are telling, when you classify, just by seeing the name, if you see over here, sir, I saw the name as live animal and I classified in section number 1 only, chapter number 1 only. They are telling, no. Please go inside, deep down inside, and then learn how to classify. Then classify, sir. So, it says over here, classification to be determined according to, you have to write over here something. Classification to be done according to title of, you can write over here, according to terms of headings and section or chapter note. Sir, when you are classifying, Baba, this title which is there, no? This title, don't go ahead and just refer the title. They are just given for ease of reference. Sir, I imported horses. So, I know that horses are live animal. I should go ahead and classify under live animals only. But just by seeing the name, I classified under chapter number 1. No. You still have to go inside and read further. It says, so, supposingly I imported horses, horses which are used in horses for polo. I imported horses for polo. So they are telling, when you imported horses, please go ahead and see the title of the heading. Heading says live horses, asses, mules. Okay, I read the terms of the heading. Then Baba, terms of the heading has to be read and then only you have to classify. So here if you see the heading ka subheading says, the subheading says horses for polo, and then only you should go ahead and classify. I hope everyone is clear. And Baba, also you should read the chapter ka notes and the section ka notes. Sir, where are the section ka notes and chapter ka notes are given? Whenever you open the first chapter of a section, in the first chapter, the section notes are given at the beginning. The section notes are given at the beginning of the section. Basically, one section, chapters are there. At the beginning of the section, section notes are given. You should read the notes. And Baba, chapter ka beginning mein, chapter notes are given. You should read the chapter note before going ahead and classify. Because see over here, this chapter covers all live animals except, means all these animals will not be covered under chapter number 1. So when you are going ahead and classifying, you saw it does not go ahead and classify fish. So supposingly I imported fish. Baba, just because I imported fish, can I go ahead and classify under chapter number 1? Because I will say, sir, live animal, fish was a live animal, I classified. No. They are telling, please go ahead and read the heading. If you see the heading, do you see fish anywhere? If you are not able to see fish only, how will you do the classification? You can't just classify in the chapter number 1 by reading the name as live animal. You still have to read the headings. And Baba, section ka notes and Baba, chapter ka notes. Because they might go ahead and say that, see, fish has to be classified under heading number 03. Means you have to go to chapter number 3. I hope everyone is clear. Let's go ahead. Next. So it says title of the section or chapter are for ease of reference. They don't have any legal force. Classification, whenever you are doing, please make sure that classification is done on the terms of the heading. Basically, you read the terms of the heading, whichever heading is given. See over here, the heading is horses, then Baba, asses. All these are headings. Headings and subheading you should read, only then classify. Along with the heading and subheading, you can go ahead and read sections. You should also go ahead and read sections and chapter notes. I hope everyone is clear. Sir, whenever I am classifying, I will read the heading, I will read the section and chapter notes, and then only classify. That is told by rule number 1. If you are unable to classify using this, if you are unable to classify using rule number 1, then Baba, go to rule number 2 to 5. Let's read rule number 2 to 5. Rule number 2 says, how will you go ahead and classify incomplete, unfinished? Please also write over here, unassembled or disassembled goods. Sir, what do you mean by unassembled or disassembled? See Baba, they are telling about classification of incomplete, unfinished. Sir, what do you mean by incomplete or unfinished goods? Supposingly car came without the seats. Baba, car has come without the seats. Then Baba, it is incomplete goods. I told, when you are sending almirahs from outside India, don't paint and send. Once it reaches India, we will get it painted, because on the way paint will get destroyed. It is incomplete almirah. It is not painted completely. Car came, the seat had not come. Because they told, sir, seats you get it done in India only. I told, I just want the car body seats, I will get it done in India only. Baba, that will still be classified as car only. They are telling, even if it is incomplete or unfinished, whenever you read an heading, if the heading says motor vehicle, that motor vehicle includes incomplete, unfinished article if it has the essential character of the complete article. Baba, when you see the body of the car has come, it has the essential character. Seats are missing. Baba, just because seats are not there, they are telling still it will be classified under car only. So incomplete, unfinished. Incomplete means it has not been completed. Unfinished means might be painting, etc. Some things are left. Incomplete, unfinished article to be classified under the main article only. They are telling, whenever you talk about an article, article includes unfinished and incomplete goods also. And Baba, supposingly dismantled cycle have come. Baba, cycles, whenever they come, wheel will be separate, base will be separate, center will be separate, chain will be separate. They are telling, disassembled. You have not assembled the cycle. They told once we transport, for ease of transportation, will not assemble. In India only you assemble. So Baba, when it came in India, it's not part of the cycles which have come or accessories. It is cycle only that has come. Heading includes unassembled item also. Or supposingly this chair which is there, the chair was made in China. From China, when they were transporting, they didn't fix the wheel and the chair together. They sent it separately. Baba, when it came to India, we assembled it. They are telling when it came to India, it was disassembled. Still, when you read chair ka heading, chair will include that chair unassembled or disassembled. So Baba, they are telling whenever you read a heading, heading includes the item, whether it is incomplete, whether it is unfinished, whether it is unassembled, whether it is disassembled also. I hope everyone is clear. Unassembled, disassembled, incomplete, unfinished article to be classified in the article as if it is a complete article only. I hope everyone is clear. Next, sir, mixture or combination of material and substances. Sir, if coffee with chicory has come, if mixture or a combination, 80% was coffee, 20% chicory was being mixed. In coffee, chicory is mixed, it will still be classified as chicory only. They are telling mixture or combination of material and substances. Whenever I say coffee ka heading. So if I say, supposing this heading says coffee, Baba, coffee ka heading, whenever you say, coffee ka heading also includes, coffee ka heading will include coffee with chicory also. Then they are telling, sir, heading includes mixture or combination of that material with other material or substances. Milk came. In milk, suppose some minerals are also there. You will say, no, in milk, vitamins are there. You will say, vitamins have come separately, milk has come separately. Baba, it will be classified as importation of milk only. I hope everyone is clear. Rubber has come, natural rubber. But in the natural rubber, 10% synthetic rubber is mixed. You will still say, it is rubber only, natural rubber only has been imported. Baba, heading includes that item mixed with some other item only. Also, gold jewelry has come. Now, gold jewelry may, 22 carat gold jewelry, 2%, 2 carat, some other things have been mixed. Actually, 24 carat is pure gold. Now, they have made 22 carat ka jewelry, some metal they would have mixed. Now, Baba, when I say jewelry has come, you'll say, no. Gold jewelry little, some other item has come little. No, Baba. Gold jewelry includes, when I say heading of gold jewelry will include gold mixed with some other metal also. Milk with vitamins is still milk. Coffee with chicory is still coffee. I hope everyone is clear. Next. So Baba, but supposingly I've got 1 minute. This is a cup which has come. Baba, the cup which is there has steel plating which is there. Inside is plastic. Now whenever you import cup outside is stainless steel. So Baba, it can be classified. You will say cup includes that cup, whether it is steel plated or not plated. But Baba, supposingly cup has come. Outside it is aluminium plated which is there. Inside it is plastic. Now whether you will classify it under household item made of steel or household item made of plastic. Now there is a confusion. In that scenario they are telling, whenever if it's a mixture or combination of material, if it's a mixture or material, mixture or combination of material, and Baba, it creates a confusion where you are not able to classify, then Baba, please move to rule number 3. So rule number 3 says, if one product which has come, suppose this cup which has come is classifiable under two headings, means one product classifiable under two headings, then what to do, sir? So it says rule number 3 ka A says specific over general description. For an example, I imported a jacket. Baba, jacket is leather jacket, so it can be classified under leather item also. Baba, jacket which has come can be classified under leather also. It can be classified under jackets also. Leather also, it can be items of leather, or it can be classified under jacket. What will you classify? They are telling, please see specific over general. General is, it's a leather item. Baba, specific it, it's a jacket. So Baba, specific over general description. One television has come. Electronic or television? Baba, specific heading is there, television. General heading is electronic. Where will you classify? Baba, specific television, specific will always prevail over general. So it says specific over general. Electronic item or television, where will you classify? You will classify a TV which has come under television because that is more specific description. I hope everyone is clear. Sir, supposingly Baba, this bottle has come. Now you will call it as item of plastic. You will call it as item of plastic, or you will, if there is a specific heading which is there, bottles, you will classify under bottle. You will classify under bottle only, right everyone? Let's go ahead. Next, sir, but mixed composite items in set, each heading regarded as specific. Baba, if there is a mixed item which has come, or there is a composite goods which has come, then in that scenario they are telling each heading will be regarded as specific. For an example, one pencil with eraser has come. Baba, it's a pencil and an eraser put together. When pencil and eraser are put together, Baba, it is a composite goods. Now in composite goods, how will you classify? They are telling pencil and Baba eraser both are to be classified as specific only. The eraser is also specific, pencil is also specific. Where will you classify? So they have gone over here and told, sir, whenever it is MCI means mixed composite goods or item in a set, please go ahead and classify using essential character test. Baba, you will have to go ahead and see what gives this the essential character. Is it the rubber which gives the essential character, or is it a pencil which gives the essential character? So Baba, if you see over here, it's a pencil. Rubber is just stuck at the end so that easily you can rub. So Baba, it is to be classified under pencil. I hope everyone is clear. I have received from outside India laptop with software. Now you will classify under laptop or software? Both are specific. Software and laptop, both are specific. Where will you classify? They are telling, Baba, you remember in GST we read about principal supply. What is principal over here? Laptop or software? Laptop. So classify under laptop. Sir, supposingly I imported a software. Along with the software, one book also has come. Big manual book has come. One big fat book they have given, and they have given software in a hard disk. I have imported a hard disk. Hard disk means software has come. Supposing this is the hard disk. In hard disk, software has come. Along with that, one book has come. Manual book. Now, is it import of the book or the hardware or the software? Baba, what is principle over here? Whether you wanted to import book or the software? Software. So essential character is given by software to be classified as software. It can happen that book is classifiable separately and software is classifiable separately. But over here they are telling you have to see essential character test and according. Both are specific. Software also has one specific heading. Book also have one specific heading. But they are telling whenever it is composite goods, it has come together, or please go ahead and classify under that heading which gives the essential character. Next, later the better rule. Sir, supposingly by applying specific over general, it was not possible. Sir, by applying essential character also, I could not find out. Then they are telling, please apply later the better rule. Later the better rule. Now, supposingly over here, supposingly, for an example, you know that Mahindra ka Imperio or some car is there, which can be used for, Baba, it is a car. Everyone here, which can be used for transportation of passenger also and transportation of goods also. Baba, this kind of one car comes of Mahindra. Now, if you go ahead and classify, 87.03 says it is for transportation of passenger. Motor vehicle for transportation of passenger. 8704, might be I am wrong with the exact heading number. Please pardon that. And transportation of goods. Now, where will you classify? It can be for transportation of goods also. I bought this vehicle for transportation of my family. Whenever we go in picnic, we transport our some goods also. Baba, I am one person who has bought this vehicle for transportation of primarily goods only. Then Baba, government is telling, when you import, on what basis will you classify? So 8703 says transportation of passenger. 8704 says it is meant for transportation of goods, which is later over here. Later is, Baba, in the sequence, if you see, which is coming later, 8704, this car will be classified under 8704. So whenever you see that something which is falling under two heading and both are under both, it is equally classifiable, then Baba, classifiable under the last heading in numerical order. When you go in numerical order, this car was classifiable under 8703 and 8704. Numerical order, 8704 is later. later is the better. So we will classify under 8704. I hope everyone is clear. Rule number 4 says akin rule. Sir, akin. Akin means with or to what it is similar to. Baba, to what it is similar to, supposingly. Applying all this, you were not able to classify something. Applying all these rules, you were not able to classify something. Supposingly, one item came. This item has come. Now, you are not able to understand where to classify this item. Heading only is not there. Sir, I imported this item. No tag, nothing. I am not able to determine only what is this. This is something. And we are, supposingly, this is a product which first time imported into India. And Baba, this product has been developed by China and there is no name only. Now, what to do? Now, in this scenario, they are telling if supposingly there is anything which has been imported of which you can't find in the heading. You are not able to find this thing in the heading. What will you do? In that scenario, they are telling whenever above rules are not applicable, might be heading unavailable. If there is heading only which is not available, then they are telling classify under similar goods heading. Baba, this item which I purchased, you will have to see similar to this what goods, what heading is available, and I'll classify it under that. So plastic flames used for car. Baba, you'll see in the car that black tin ke liye plastic flames are used. There separate heading is not there. So when plastic flames are imported for putting in car, that tint, etc., that specific heading is not there. Where will you classify? It will be classified under builder wear of plastic shutter, Baba, because builder wares of plastic shutters are also used for preventing sunlight. Plastic flames are also for preventing sunlight. So they are telling we will go ahead and classify under builder wear of plastic shutter. Whichever akin rule says, if supposedly heading is unavailable, please go ahead and classify the articles under the similar goods ka heading. I hope everyone is clear. Next. Sir, rule number 5 talks about packing material and containers. Baba, in packing material and containers, I'll tell you simply. Supposingly, I have gone ahead and imported hard disk. When I imported hard disk, this cover, this case is given along with the hard disk. Generally, it is given along with the hard disk. Now, if it is given along with the hard disk, when I imported a hard disk and the cover also came along with it, the case or the container came along with it, we will go ahead and say we have imported hard disk only. We will not go ahead and say hard disk imported separately, case imported separately. I hope everyone is clear. Secondly, sir, supposingly this t-shirt I bought from outside India, t-shirt came along with a bubble wrap packing. Baba, will I say t-shirt came separately and bubble wrap came separately? Baba, it is still classifiable under t-shirt only. The whole packing material, if camera case, etc. is coming along with the main product, classify with the main product. Sir, whenever a case or a container which is specifically made for an item is coming along with the item, necklace are coming in necklace pouches, necklace boxes, Baba, they will be classified along with the main product only. Sir, empty boxes, cases, gold case. Sir, supposingly I imported only carton boxes so that in India I can use them for packing. Baba, when I import carton boxes, they are to be classified independently. Supposingly, along with this hard disk, I told them, do one thing, send me a gold cover of the hard disk. Baba, gold cover that is not ordinarily given along with the hard disk to be classified independently. I hope everyone is clear. Baba, one gun I imported, gun comes with a gun case. Now, normal gun case, if it is given, to be classified along with the main article. But supposingly, they have gone ahead and given me a gold case. I told, make a gold case of gun and then send the gun. Baba, gold case to be classified separately, gun to be classified separately. Ordinary packing to be classified with the main article, special unordinary packings to be classified separately. I hope everyone is clear. Next. Then it says, Baba, also remember one thing, durable packing repetitively which can be used, returnable packings which are there, are to be classified separately. So Baba, whenever it is packing which is done for repetitive use, like cylinders are for carrying gas. Now Baba, cylinders can be used again and again. Baba, cylinders are to be classified separately. You can't go ahead and say along with gas we'll classify cylinder also. I hope everyone is clear. Repetitive use ke liye durable packings which are done, Baba, those are to be classified independently. Next, rule number 6, Baba, classification of sub heading. Classification of subheadings, they are telling over here. Subheadings, when you go ahead and classify, again read the terms of the subheading, read the notes of the subheading, and then apply rule number 1 to 5, mutatis mutandis. Baba, they are telling when you go ahead and classify subheadings also, please apply the terms of the subheading, notes, and apply rule number 1 to 5, mutatis mutandis. I want to quickly go ahead and revise what we have learned till now. Everyone over here, we started learning classification. Classification, my first thing on the left hand side. Classification, what do you mean by classification means finding out your correct HSN code for the commodity which you have imported or which you are going ahead and exporting, so that you find out the correct rate of duty. Classification, you will go ahead and classify your goods in the Custom Tariff Act. Custom Tariff Act has two schedules. First schedule gives you the import duty rate. Second schedule gives you the export duty rate. Baba, then we had HSN code. HSN code, 8 digits are there. Baba, 21 sections are there, which are divided into chapters, heading, subheading, and tariff item. The first two digits of the HSN code is the chapter number. The second two digits are the heading. The third two digits are the subheading, and the fourth two digits are the tariff item. I hope everyone is clear. Tariff item ka code. Next, sir. Then we have explanatory note, and then we have general rules of interpretation. Explanatory notes are 3 ... dash 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 dash. Baba, dash means the article of the heading. Dash dash means the subclassification of the immediate preceding article. Then Baba, you have dash 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 dash, which is basically again subclassification of the immediate preceding dash or dash dash. I hope everyone is clear. Next, sir, we have percentage. Percentage just means the percentage, that is the rate of duty which is to be applied directly on the value of goods under section number 14. Sir, standard is applicable if preferential rate is not there. General rule of interpretation, rule number 1 told, sir, the title of section and chapter, the titles are just for ease of reference. Classification, when you do, please read classification. Whenever you do, please read the terms of heading, section, and chapter notes. Sir, where are the section and chapter notes placed? They are placed at the beginning. Sections, at the beginning of the section. Section notes are there. At the beginning of the chapter, chapter notes are there. Sir, chapter notes and section notes which are there are a part of the statute. I hope everyone is clear. Next, sir, if you are unable to determine by applying rule number 1, then apply rule number 2 to 5. Rule number 2 may A is there, rule number 2 may B is there. A told, sir, if it is unassembled, disassembled, incomplete, unfinished goods, classify with the main article only. Sir, then it told, if there is a mixture or combination, if the article which you have imported is a mixture or combination, then Baba, please go ahead and classify with an article always include mixture or combination of that material with other material. I hope everyone is clear. Next, sir, rule number 3 is applicable. Sir, supposingly you are not able to classify as per 2B. It was a mixture, but you are not able to classify as per 2B, or by any other reason you are not able to apply rule number 1 or rule number 2. Then first one told, please apply specific over general. General description over general description, apply specific description. Second is essential character test. Baba, in case of mixed goods, composite goods, or Baba, if it is item inset means, sir, scissor, comb, everything was put together and it was put as a item and sent. I hope everyone is clear. So Baba, in that scenario, they are telling, please apply essential character test. Basically, the principal supply may, please go ahead and classify it. The next is later the better. Sir, if supposing you are not able to apply any of the above 3A or 3B, then sir, please go ahead and classify numerically C, whichever is the last classification, classify that goods under that classification. Rule number 4 says akin rule means what is the good similar to under that class, under the similar goods ka classification, please classify the goods, because these goods might not have heading. So go ahead and classify these goods under that heading which are similar goods. I hope everyone is clear. Rule number 5 talked about packing material or container ka case mein, camera case to be classified along with the main camera case, guitar cases, musical instrument ka case, necklace ka case or container, if it is coming, please go ahead and classify along with the main item. if it is coming along with the main item. If it is coming separately, only if I have imported necklace case, Baba classify separately. Sir, supposingly I have gone ahead and imported gold case, etc. Baba, they are to be classified independently. Durable or repetitive use ka containers which are there, they are to be classified separately. Next, rule number 6 is there. Rule number 6 went ahead and told classification of subheading. Subheading ka when you do classification, terms of the subheading to be read, notes to be read, and then apply rule number 1 to 5, mutatis mutandis. Mutatis mutandis. Now, the next one over here is market or trade parallels. Market or trade parallels theory. Baba, what do you mean by market or trade parallels theory? Market or trade parallels theory says that, Baba, if any goods is there which is not being defined by the custom tariff act, then the last resort is to go ahead and take the goods to be classified as per the trade understanding, basically the market or the trade understanding of that goods. Baba, so if there is a goods which is not being defined in the custom tariff act and you want to classify, then how will you classify? Please go ahead and take the market understanding, that is the trade understanding, or the how the dealers or the consumers understand those goods, and accordingly go ahead and classify. Baba, one very important case law over here. Baba, Connaught Plaza Restaurant Limited, where McDonald's was holding soft serve as other dairy product. Baba, soft serve which is given in McDonald's, they were holding it as other dairy product. However, soft serve we all know is an ice cream, and hence applying the common trade parallels theory, soft serve was being classified as ice cream. I hope everyone is clear. Market or trade parallels theory, whenever definition of the goods do not help you to classify, basically when the custom tariff act does not provide you the definition of the goods, go ahead and classify using the market understanding, that is the trade understanding of their goods. The next one over here is project imports. What do you mean by project import? Project import means, supposingly for doing a project in India, you need to import lot of goods, machineries which are there. Baba, all the goods to be classified under separate heading. So government went ahead and told, Baba, that will create an unnecessary issue. So whenever for projects you are importing lot of machineries, all of them to be classified under one heading, which is 9801. Project import can be for new project, or project import can be for substantial expansion of an existing project. Substantial expansion means the installed capacity which is there, 25% increment should be there in the installed capacity. Project imports can be, what are the eligible project? Eligible project can be industrial project, irrigation project, power project, mining project, oil exploration project, or it can be any other project which is notified by the central government. Central government has notified now project which can be monorail project, metro rail projects, etc. Sir, eligible imports are machinery. However, along with the machinery, components and raw material which are required for the initial setup and consumables up to 10% are also allowed. Sir, what is the treatment? Baba, all the items which are imported under project import will be classified under 9801, and one single rate of custom duties shall be levied. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. We are done with classification of goods. Baba, if you loved the video, please go ahead and comment and let me know how was the video, how did you enjoy it. Right, everyone. And Baba, keep revising, keep practicing. All the best.